really good in the team final in all four of her routines. And a sixth straight world team title for the USA women. Here is Jordan Childs.
Incredible Yurchenko double full from Jordan Childs. Almost a stuck landing. Her feet are together. She's tied in the air. What more could you ask for? As John mentioned earlier, I think Jordan is her strongest on vault now than she's ever been.
Ho-hum. I mean, she's not out of breath. It was like, yeah, I do that. I can do this.
She finished, took a hop off, and said, all right, time for the next.
Yeah. Come on, hurry up with the score.
It's almost like if she could check her own little watch on her wrist, she would. Are we done?
Exactly.
Look at that height. Everything almost perfectly in line. We watch in slow motion, and of course, in slow motion, you can see more deductions. Little feet coming apart. There. But overall, she lands pretty much directly in the center. She takes one hop back. I mean, I don't really know what more you could ask for. Go, Joe!
And the two Americans, too, back to what we were talking about. Now, they're still young. She's 21. Jade Carey's 22. But go compete in college, UCLA, Jade Carey, Oregon State, come back to the elite level. Much more often we're seeing that, and it's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
Completely wrong.
As we mentioned earlier, for people like Elizabeth Seitz, Ellie Black, competing in older age, we also have Jordan and Jade paving the way for those who go to college and want to come back into the elite scene. Here's Jordan's second ball. Wow, really powerful entrance. Putting her hands down on that mat, the way she enters onto the vault table and then springs right off, you can snap your fingers and she's off the table quicker than that. Once again, those landings matters, and she almost stuck that. I'm expecting a very high score for Jordan Childs.
The aftermath, again, is like, she could just keep doing this for about a half hour. Oh, you want me to do it again? Okay, I'll do it again.
You know what? In practicing with Jordan, that's exactly how she is, too. She's like, oh, another one? Sure. Oh, another one? Yeah, no worries. Oh, another...
That's the set you get.
I'm curious to know what score she's going to get in comparison for podium. John, what are your thoughts? Where do you think she'll land?
Well, she's going to be in the lead. There's no doubt about it. I mean, that was an exceptional vault, and I think better than she did in qualifications, honestly.
See that clap at the end? She's very excited about that. Listen, if I could do those vaults, I would be proud of that, too.
Okay.
No, she's got a second one. Okay, so another interesting thing is Shirley's jump. Here's her score. Vault 2.
Number one.
14.2.
There it is. 14.35 is the average, so she takes over that top spot.
Let's go, Jay. You got this.
Colleen Deviard, France says congratulations. World Vault Silver Medalist wants the gold medal this time around. Jade Carey.
This is the hardest vault in the competition, difficulty-wise. And Jade almost sticks it. I did recognize some foot separation off the table, but the difficulty is probably going to trump that.
Top qualifier for this final. And as John said early to start this show, a bit of a motivation, too, that what happened at the Olympics in vault. Now, she came back, obviously, and won the floor gold medalist at the Olympics, but that's still somewhat in her mind.
Yeah, the adrenaline that you can feel before competing really does translate into how fast you run, how hard you can block off the table. When I say block, I mean right there when your hands leave the table. And so if you use that nervous energy to run faster, there's a good chance you may mess up because you don't train like that. Once again, we saw that from Wittenberg. We saw that from Andrade. And unfortunately, we did see that from Jade in Tokyo. But here, so far, that first vault looks great. She can hit the second one. Once again, I believe Team USA. Simone's artistic wall is going to be on the podium. Jordan, no doubt in my mind.
And Jordan, obviously, big influence has been Simone Biles and her coaches, too, working there. Jade, coached by her dad, Brian. 14-7-3-3. How about that? Wow.
And that 9.1 execution, once again, always a joy to see a 9 on the execution scoreboard.
Second ball coming up.
Chenko double full, very clean for Jade Carey. I do wonder, first and second between Jade and Jordan, I believe her difficulty, for Jade's sake, may bring her up a bit higher.
The number for Jordan Chiles, 14-3-5. That's the number that leads. It's the average between the two vaults, so we'll see. Mentioned 2019 when the U.S. last had two women on the podium in the vault final.
This replay. Very tight twisting off the table. Bit of a pipe down. Let's watch her head. Very tight. She spots the landing. John, I'd love to bring you in.
Yeah, you know, she scored a 14.366 on that vault in the qualification round. She needs a little over a 14, a 14.033 to tie Jordan Chiles. And you know what? I'm just going to tell you right now, she's going to get it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's going to happen. Not to ruin the suspense, but because we don't know officially, but yeah, it seems like it is. It was Simone Biles, Jade Carey on the podium together, gold, silver in 2019. The last time that happened, 14-3 is the number. 14-5-1-6 into first place, Jade Carey.